Dear listener, welcome to Hour of Destiny devotional with Reverend Mike Inyola of Habitation of Winners Ministry International. Happy listening. We cry, Abba Father, hallowed be your name, hallowed be your name, hallowed be your name. Hello, good morning. Welcome to Hour of Destiny Daily Devotional and Spiritual Breakfast with Reverend Mike Eniola. Welcome to Friday, the second day of September 2022. Open your heart this morning and receive today's prayers and prophetic declaration. Today, we are still praying New Month prayer. The Lord laid in my heart and I declared it yesterday that September is our month of overflow. I am still praying for everyone hearing the sound of my voice today that in all areas, in every aspect of life, you will experience divine overflow in Jesus' name. The Lord will open the book of remembrance concerning you and your family today, and in this month of September, the Lord will open your heavens in Jesus' name. The Lord said to the children of Israel, He said, I am removing you from land of bondage and captivity. I am taking you to a land that flows with milk and honey, a land where you will not toil or struggle or labor much, but you will get great harvest. I am praying that same prayer for somebody who is saying amen this early morning, that the Lord will lead you to a place of surplusity. The Lord will lead you to a place where abundance are waiting in Jesus' name. This Friday, I pray and I plead on your behalf that let God of heaven open your way. May the Lord open your heavens. May the Lord send helpers to you in Jesus' name. I want to pray for the sick and the elderly this morning. Are you sick in any part of your body? Maybe doctors have said there is no way for you. Maybe they have given up on you. In fact, maybe they are just counting days that you will soon give up. But that is doctor's report. And I want to let you know that doctors do not have final say. It is only God who has the final say over your life. And what I'm hearing God saying to me to tell you this morning is that you still have a lot to do for God and for His kingdom. So I rebuke death over your life and I cast out the spirit of death that have been hovering your life in Jesus' name. I rebuke death and I pray that life of God will take over your life. You will not die, but the hand of the Almighty will uphold you and cause you to rejoice in Jesus' name. Also, I am praying for the elderly. I pray in the name of the Lord that the Lord will renew your strength as He renews your age in Jesus' name. Every one of us, as we step out today, you will go out in peace and you will return back home in peace in Jesus' name. Oh, I am saying to somebody that in this month of September, in this Ember month, the best of your picture shall not be used as obituary or transition. They say early transition, painful exit, it shall not be your portion in Jesus' name. The number of your days and years you will live to fulfill in Jesus' name. You will not be a victim of kidnapping. You will not be a victim of terrorism. You will not be a victim of banditry. You will not be a victim of evil men and women. Stray bullet will not hit you. The Lord will protect you and your family, and God will cause your heavens to open, and you will have every cause to rejoice in Jesus' name. All of you that are supporting Hour of Destiny, all of you that are rebroadcasting this daily devotional on daily basis through various social medias, and those of you that are supporting us in one way or the other to remain in this work, I pray and I ask that the Lord will open the heavens and bless you the more in Jesus' name. I want to pray for all our various groups, all our coordinators, state coordinators and representatives across the nations. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. You are blessed and you are lifted. Somebody shout hallelujah. Praise God. Let me make this announcement to all my people that by the grace of God, my new book, Don't Create That Mess, is widely in circulation now. By the grace of God, the book is in the city of Maiduguri, the capital of Borno State. By the grace of God, today we are going to post or paste the number of our sister through whom you can get the book in Maiduguri as is. Also, I need to remind us that the books are in Lokoja, the city of Lokoja. Also, you can come to our headquarters church and get a copy. We have the books in a lorry. One of our
sister. She's in the office of the deputy governor. We have pasted her number. It's on the platform. Pick a number. Call her. The books are in the lorry. Also in Edo, in Benin. The books are there. In the city of Abuja, we have the books there. In Lagos, the books are there. And also in all over, the books are everywhere. We are still coming up with more cities in Yola, Taraba, all over. We are still coming up. We appreciate our brethren in the East. Several people have been sending messages to us to serve as our coordinators and representatives. We are grateful. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Now let's go to hear the word as we progress in the topic of the power of unity. The power of unity. I told us at the beginning that God wants us to be united. It is the will of God that we, His children, should be united. We read from the book of Psalm 133 from verse 1 to the end, where the Bible says, "Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity." The last verse says, "There the Lord will command His blessing." Where there is unity, there is commanded blessings of God. And since 2 days now, we've been looking at ingredients or agent of unity. What can aid unity to be practicalized? Is it number one? Genuine love. There must be mutual love before we can say there is unity. Also, say number two, you must respect the feelings and the opinion of other people. You don't say you are the one that is always right. Let other people too air their own views. Respect their opinion. If you don't do, they may just listen to you, but they will not carry out your instruction. Today, another agent or ingredient for unity is what I call truthfulness. It is good for us to be truthful. If you are not a truthful person, then don't expect people to live in unity with you in your community. I remember in South Africa, during the presidency of late Nelson Mandela, he organized a Truth and Reconciliation Commission in order to reconcile the aggrieved people, the Afrikaners, the whites, the Swahili, all of them, you know, because he knew that before that time, so many things had happened in that nation. So he set up that Truth and Reconciliation Commission to bring everybody together. The same thing I am saying to us this morning, be truthful. If you want to enjoy unity in our nation today, there's so much cheating, so much abnormality going on in our nation, and every day our leaders will be telling us that they want us to be united. When some people see themselves over and above others, there can be no unity in that regard. So I put it to you, everybody hearing the sound of my voice this morning, before unity can be achieved, you must live in love, you must respect the feelings and the opinions and the saying of other people. Then number three, you must allow truth to be in place. There must be truthfulness. There must be honesty. There must be righteousness. Outside of this or minus this, there can be no unity. I pray for everybody hearing the sound of my voice this morning that the power of unity will come and rest upon you, between you and your spouse, in your family, in your community, in your neighborhood, in our nation. I pray that unity will reign and prevail in Jesus' name. You are welcome once again to the month of September, the first of the four Ember month, where the Lord has promised that this is our month of overflow. You will enjoy it. You will experience it. You will talk about it in Jesus' name. If you have not given God your thanksgiving offering, today is second day of the month. You can still do it by giving God, by sending your thanksgiving offering to God as a way of saying, "God, thank you for keeping me and preserving my life." And also secondly, if you have not given somebody something this early month, do it. This is still early of the month. Give something to somebody and bless a soul today. The Lord bless you. The Lord increase you. And if you have not given your life to Jesus, I invite you to come and say yes to the Master. Give your life to Him so that on the last day, He can welcome you to heaven. No amount of blessings you have in this world, if Jesus is not on the inside of you, if you refuse to accept Him as Lord and Savior, everything will amount to nothing. But if you have Jesus on the inside of you, you will enjoy eternity and it will be well with you. God bless you. Have a wonderful Friday and happy new month again. In Jesus' name, amen.
As I live, open as I breathe, let my whole life be expressions of your ways.
Hour of Destiny. presented by Reverend Mike Inyola of Habitation of Winners Ministry International. We invite you to worship with us on Sunday by 8:30 a.m. and Wednesday 5 p.m. Venue is Glory Cathedral of Habitation of Winners Church after WAEC office along Cruiser Road, Lokoja, Kogi State, Nigeria. For prayers and counseling, contact us on 0806-211-5571 or 0803-797-4748. Rose Farm produced the program. Thank you for listening and God bless you.
We cry of our Father, hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name.
Thank you for listening to Reverend Mike Inyola. Please stick to your screens for more of his messages. Goodbye for now. See you some other time, God willing.